Hello students, so we are going to continue our chapter 2 nutrition in animals, 7th class, and I am Amita. Let's see what we have in this class. So in previous video we were talking about process of digestion, and I think I have told you about the steps IDAAE, I don't act, attack, edit. So I for ingestion, that's right. Don't, D for digestion. A, act, act means absorption. So here you can correct yourself. Absorption spelling is wrong here. Attack, assimilation, ejection, edit. So like this, you can just practice it again and learn the steps. Now five process of digestion, as I earlier told you, we take in food inside our body through our mouth, that is ingestion. We break down of food material or food substances happen into simpler substances, that is digestion. And then digested food is absorbed into body cell, that is absorption. And in assimilation, absorbed food is used to provide energy. And finally, ejection is removal of undigested food. So I hope you have revised all these things. Now, B for buccal cavity, O for esophagus, and then S means stomach. So digestion in stomach, what is happening in stomach? So what is stomach? It is a muscular thick walled bag of J shaped, and food is digested or churned into semi-solid, and there is gastric juice which is secreted from the wall of stomach. And this includes hydrochloric acid also and few enzymes. And enzymes, what are they? They will help in breakdown of food. They will help in conversion of larger complex food materials into simpler ones. And what is the function of hydrochloric acid over here? And you have remembered the formula. Do you know the formula of hydrochloric acid? If you don't know, HCl is the formula for hydrochloric acid, and it will kill the harmful bacteria which is present in the stomach. And in stomach, it is an acidic medium because hydrochloric acid is present. Now, what happens in small intestine? So in small intestine, completion of digestion and absorption takes place. Okay, so it is small intestine is responsible for the absorption also and digestion of nutrients. And the digestive process is done by enzymes. I told you they will help in breakdown of complex materials into simpler ones, and they are produced by the pancreas. And it is a site for absorption of amino acids, fats, glucose and some large molecules. To improve the efficiency of absorption, it is necessary to increase surface area. Now, the third point where you can see here, it is a site for absorption of amino acids. So, proteins, they are, converted into amino acids, and fats into fatty acids in glycerol, and carbohydrates into glucose. Okay, so this we will remind again at the end. So, what is the function of intestine, small intestine? So, it will break down the food mixture. In this, under this, three important parts of intestine are included: pancreas, liver and gallbladder. Now, liver and gallbladder. So, these are called accessory digestive glands, and liver is the largest internal organ. Okay. So, this will liver will produce bile or bile juice. The bile which is produced is stored in the gallbladder. Okay, and the bile will act upon the fats, which is they will break down these fats. Another accessory digestive organ is pancreas. It will produce or secrete pancreatic juice or fluid, and they will also contain some kind of digestive enzymes, those which are responsible for breaking down of complex food material into simpler ones, and that passes to the small intestine. And these enzymes help to further breaking down of the carbohydrates, proteins, lipids in the lipids. For example, I told you carbohydrates, they will be broken down into sugar or glucose, proteins into amino acids and the fats, they will be broken down into fatty acids and glycerol. So there are some terms which you may not understand, but this is these things are not in our NCERT, and these are in higher classes. Okay, so what extra things happen in small intestine? So absorption in small intestine, you know, it is a very important process, and it is done by villi. Okay, so these villi are finger-like projections. The inside of the small intestine is lined with millions of tiny, small, finger-like projections, and they are called villi. So they are in finger-shaped, and villi will absorb nutrients from our body. And you can see here, villi is a plural of villus, and then you can see plural is villi. Okay. What is assimilation? So now we have done I for ingestion, D for digestion, A for absorption, now assimilation. So what is assimilation? So many people, they will confuse the term digestion, absorption and assimilation. So digestion is generally breaking down of the large molecules into smaller ones, and absorption, what it will happen, small molecules are taken up from the digestive system, and they will be taken up and they will go into the blood streams, I mean into each body cells. Assimilation, what will happen, these digestive food will help to produce energy. So here it is written, when these molecules and food molecules, digestive molecules, are incorporated into tissues of the body. And why they are incorporated? They are incorporated for producing energy so that we can do various kinds of work. Okay. So these three differences are very important. Ingestion. Last point is ingestion. And last boss, LRA, B for buccal cavity, O for esophagus, and double S, that is stomach and intestine, and L for large intestine, and then rectum and anus. So large intestine, it is wider, shorter than smaller intestine, 1.5 meter in length, and it will absorb water and salt from undigested food. And the remaining waste matter is passed through rectum. In rectum, the waste material is passed. And time to time, the fecal matter means waste material. And the waste material is removed from the final part, that is called anus. And this process is called ejection. So ejection will start from large intestine, and then it will go to rectum, and then it will end in the anus. Now let's revise certain things. So what is the difference between small intestine and large intestine? So small intestine is longer, has small width, but large intestine is shorter but broad. Okay, and small intestine, it is in between stomach and large intestine. Large intestine is the last part of the digestive system before rectum and anus. And small intestine, it will help in digestion also and in absorption. But large intestine, it is purely for reabsorption. Okay, all the important materials are reabsorbed of food, and it will also help in elimination of waste. Small intestine, it will absorb carbohydrate, protein, fat, minerals and vitamins. But in large intestine, it will absorb water, nutrients and salts. Okay. So this is the summary of all the process. So I'm not reading it, but you can read it when you are watching this video. Now, salivary gland will produce saliva. Okay, secretion means producing. It will produce saliva. Stomach will produce acid. Which kind of acid? Hydrochloric acid, HCl. Liver will produce or secrete bile juice. And this bile juice is stored in gallbladder. Rectum, it is the storage of undigested food, feces. Feces means waste material. Small intestine, it is the place where digestion is completed and also absorption takes place. Large intestine, absorption of water takes place, where we can use the word reabsorption of water and salts. Now, food components and what are the products of digestion. So, carbohydrate, they will get converted into sugar or glucose. Proteins, they will get converted into amino acids. Fats, they will get converted into fatty acids and glycerol. So this was for your revision. I hope you have understood. If you have any doubt, please call me and text me. Thank you so much.